So I got the rims and I want to go and put them on the car. But as with everything else in the Nova project, that couldn't be done. Not without a little modification. So in order to put these rims on the car, I needed to make some changes. And so let's go take a look at what changes I had to make to be able to enjoy the rims on the Nova. So I have my rim in place and just gonna show, here is the spacing between the actual rim and the shock. And then of course the spacing I have between the rim and the back wall of the wheel well. And then for the front, because as I stated, I do want this rim to, you know, I am going to drop the Nova and I want the wheel to be able to fit inside the wheel well. I took my straight edge, put it up against my rim, and you can see that the straight edge, which is this side here that's touching the rim, it's about an inch away from the edge of the wall for my quarter panel. Now, I'm going to add myself a little security and put in a small spacer in between the rim and the mounting pad, because I now know that I have some space to work with for the front. And this will give me added clearance if needed. Now when you're calculating the backspace of the wheel, you also have to take into consideration the tire. The tire tends to want to bulge. And so of course up here is not going to bulge, but if you get a tire that's too wide, or at least wider than the actual rim, then you're going to get a bulge, and then that bulge adds to the measurement of the rim. So in this case I have a 10-inch rim, okay, slightly smaller than 10-inch, and so the wheel that I'm choosing is 10 inches of rubber for the footprint. So that is one of the other measurements that you have to worry about once you get past the rim portion of it. Now I can always, if need be, cut, just like many people do, cut a little away from the quarter panel lip, and that will give me even more added clearance. So I do have some options when I was choosing this rim, and those are the things that I considered as I was looking into it. Now the last thing I had to do is look at the screws. Now you can see that they barely peek out of the hole. So I got the wheel off, and now you can see how short the studs are. So I need to make those longer. So I bought some longer studs. And so these are, I forget what they are. These are a total of 2 7/8 inch studs, so basically 3-inch studs. And so what I have to do is knock these guys out and then press these guys in. So I got the studs out, and I just basically used this mallet, and I just give them a couple of whacks and they just pop right out. And then here's a stud that I pulled out of the wheels, and these are the new ones, so you can see the difference in size. Now this part here, the newer edge, is wider than the original. So for these holes, I actually had to drill them out, make them a little bit larger, so that as I'm pressing this new stud in, it can slide in through that hole. And I didn't drill them out too much, because I do want some, you know, I want this to be able to press in and stay in there real tight. So the way I do it is take a couple washers, and here's the original nut that was on the Nova. So what I do is I pop that cap off, and I'm able to thread in the stud right through that nut. And then with an impact wrench, I basically try to get that on there. And I do it in steps, because as I'm impacting, this stud and this nut actually heats up. And so to try to prevent it from seizing up, I did put some copper-based anti-seize, basically this stuff here, anti-seize lubricant, so that way I don't have a, any problems with the nut seizing up right onto the stud. But I gotta do it in steps because it does heat up. So I gotta just go, and it takes a while, but it gets done. So I'm gonna continue and get it all done. So here it is, the rim installed, and I have a jack under the pumpkin, under the rear axle, compressing the suspension. So both wheels are off the ground, and this is what it would look like if the car was on the ground. Now I'm thinking that I may do a 2-inch drop, but I'll have to decide later on when I have the tire on, and I'll make that decision once I see what the car looks like with all four rims and all four tires on it. Then I could always make adjustments to the coilovers, and then of course, if I want to lower the axle, I mean, if I want to lower the body, I have to raise the axle, and to do that, I would need lowering blocks. And I will decide the amount of measurement I need, once I have it all situated. Now, as far as the threads, you can see now they peek out. So I will have to probably cut them down, depending on the nuts that I get for these. But most likely I'll be cutting off the tip that doesn't have any threads. So I will be doing that for all of them. But now I have enough threads in there to work in the nut and to ensure that the wheel won't fall off on me. But there it is. That's the rim. It's kind of hard to tell how it looks, but it's finally done. Hope you enjoyed. Thank you for watching.